I said good day, sir!
Welcome everybody back to here to another night of the defense season number 3. I'm your host, Obi-Wan Kenobi, bringing you this tournament with $20,000 USD prize pool up for grabs. Playing through our group stages, our game tonight comes from Group A, where it's Lions Pride going up against Virtus Pro. Virtus Pro already 2-2 here in the group, and Lions Pride sitting there at 1-1. So hey, double the amount of games made by Virtus Pro, but of course they are still sitting with those two extra losses up their sleeve. There's a couple of games not gone quite the way they really expected. Tonight though, they are hoping that they'll move themselves up in the group rankings and make sure they get themselves into at least that third or fourth position. You must be 4 or higher if you want to advance through the group stages and get into the playoffs. Of course, if you want to check out all the details as far as the defense goes, head over to the-defense.com and you'll find everything you need to know about the defense. It is all available over there for your viewing pleasure. And for your viewing pleasure, I give you your draft. Girl! Drafting time. That's right. Have a couple of hours break between G League and now. We had a one-game thing at 1 p.m. Like, yeah! IG versus LGD. You, yeah! Give me a good game. Give me a good game. And game is over. I got nothing left. So, ended up having a little bit of a break, taking care of a couple of things, and then coming back and saying, hey, excite me, defense. Excite me. Give me something good. Give me something different, something unusual. That's what I'm hoping for. Virtus Pro, they gave it to us a couple of times ago. They went a little bit more standard last night, but they did run a Zeus. They tried to run the Zeus. Didn't really work, but that wasn't Zeus's fault. Really, Zeus actually worked well in that lineup. The only downside was that Pugna was then chosen. He ended up being able to push her, and the supports really got nothing. They ended up trying to run this Lashrak and something else. I cannot remember off the top of my head what it was. In fact, I think I have their lineup over on my side here. Nope, that was their one between them and Empire as their last game in the Revenge. Which, of course, they did play last night. They did play that one last night. If you want to check out the details, they are over in the match ticker. We see them run a little bit of, that was Lions Pride. I should be looking at Virtus Pro, which was very, very different. Their last game was up against the Brazilians last night, which they convincingly took. They managed to get the Bounty Hunter through and play around with him. But El Pride are going to ban him out tonight. Also take out the Nibirian Assassin. Reserve time. Or Nyx. Nyx. Reserve time. Wisp as well as Undyne being banned out here by NS. So going for a little bit more of his style. But of course, then again, you look at the other lineup and you see, like, Stalk LP, you see Vigos there, Massacre, Android, and Zako. I don't know if that's exactly how you say his name, but that's how I was told it's meant to be pronounced. And then through Virtus Pro's lineup, you see a lineup that everybody knows. That's crazy down the very, very bottom. Santa, KSI, M, and used to be known as Illidan, and NS, the final one there as also the coach of the women's team from Virtus Pro. Might also be because his girlfriend's in that team, but he is the drafter for this Virtus Pro side. And so far, he knows he's up against Queen of Pain as well as a Nake, so Lions Pride getting the fun pickups from the very, very start. Gives him a strong solo mid, considering Templar Assassin has already not been picked. And we kind of thought that we'd see that Templar Assassin coming up from the middle lane for Virtus Pro. It's just a nice blocking kind of pickup. Only downside is now they know that Queen of Pain is going to be in there, so we look for Silence or some form of control hero that can go in towards that mid lane and go up against the Queen of Pain. Because I think Virtus Pro are one of those teams that like to dabble around with the Obsidian Destroyer. So I won't be completely locked off my socks if OD does appear in this game, because it does really completely limit what Queen of Pain is capable of doing. Because we always talk about Queen of Pain getting up to that level 7, level 8 mainly. Then that's when you can have the 4 points up in the scream, 1 point up in the ultimate, and they have enough points up in the blink. And of course, if you go Sting, it takes you another couple levels too. But to mainly have the mana pool once you hit that level, and that's what it's all about. And all right, so Rubick and Luna, whatever's good, you take it back. Because Rubick has been really the star support for everything these days. We saw him being played by Chuan earlier today, able to steal what we had reverse polarity at one point, and then it was Finger of Death, we played around a lot more with that lineup, and yeah, it's a dangerous, dangerous thing, able to have two very large ulti combos in the middle of an engagement, and because There is still a limit to some things he can steal, but right now, having Quap as well as Connell abilities available to him, he'll be very, very happy with this one. And at this point, Virtus.pro already got nice counter push. They got good team fight control. And that comes through both the Darkseer, who can go the offlane, as well as from the Rubick. And Darkseer more than likely will be happy to go towards that offlane. If Lion's Pride are going to run very, very standard lanes, then we're looking towards the Nakes heading up towards that top lane to try and farm up. And dealing with double Iron Shell very early on is rather difficult as a Nakes, because you're looking for a lot more farm at the very early stages of the game, and having that creep wave push under the tower is more of a nuisance kind of thing. But it's going to be difficult for Darkseer to get himself into the mix on that top lane, because he'll be taking a lot of harassment damage from Coddle. We still don't know who their second support hero of Lion's Pride is, and we'll have to keep our eyes open to say, well, reserve time, what their offlaner is going to be, or do we see the Coddle team up with the Nakes and then go on the offlane? We see something like a Lina or a Lashrak. And then we've got a lot of push potential coming out from Lion's Pride to be aggressive on that offlane. We've seen Lifestealer. The open wounds is a really large slow, and that's able to couple up with those large, like, the long animation casting time AoE stuns of Lashrak as well as Lina. And Jakiro is still the first banned out by NS. So he's looking for the extra supporter for the top lane. Aim the bounty hunter, so now starts to ban out the offlane. He's almost trying to force Lion's Pride to run an aggressive tri-lane against him, but against Luna Rubick, I suppose we'll still see like NS's normal Lashrak come out to play in this lineup. They've already got the setup from Rubick. And that was, it was something we were also talking about in the second matchup. I apologize if I'm referring to G League way too much, but hey, you learn a lot from watching these games. But something we're referring to with the IG lineup, where they ended up having two setup heroes, and it just doesn't work. Like, normally, like, Rubick is what we class as a setup support hero, and you want to couple him up with a stun hero or a damaging style hero that works with that setup. So, large animation time, Rubick telekinesis sets up for that one. Open wounds sets up for a large animation casting time. Like, these are kind of things. Shadow Demon, another setup. In fact, that was the combination that was used by IG, was the Shadow Demon as well as the Rubick together. But it doesn't really work because you've got two setup kind of guys. So it's more, it's a very defensive style. It does scale a lot better into the late game, or the mid game, I should say. But for the very early stages, it doesn't give you that level of aggression you're normally searching for. Magnetor is the final ban out as well from NS. So again, another offlane hero being banned out. Kind of forced them into a bit more of a Windrunner-style position for Lion's Pride for their offlaner, unless they want to pick up like a... Well, actually, he's still available in the pool, so we could be looking at Lone Druid to make a bit of a pickup 10 seconds for Lion's Pride, and they can run him on the offlane, or they run the aggressive lane, or they can run him on the safe lane. There's so many options available. Lion's Pride, they still don't know what to do against Virtus.pro. The mid lane that is hard to ban out against, and I'm pretty sure Gyrocopter should be... Actually, no, even then Gyrocopter, Queen of Plain just will blink away, so they still need a silencing hero that can lock that down. The Rubick pickup is not enough, and they still ban out the Templar Assassin, even though Queen of Pain is going to be in that middle lane. And they still banned it out, because we have talked in the past, I know, I think it was actually Aoi and I were talking about the matchup between TA as well as Queen of Pain. And really, no matter how it works, the matchup with TA should be won by TA in the later portions of the game, unless Queen of Pain can find a very early opening. And that's normally from some level of overcommitment that will come out from a Queen of Pain and not through anything else. And right now, more than likely, we'll probably see the remaining hero being the Invoker for Virtus.pro, as it's the last major hero that would normally go up against Queen of Pain and go Quas Wex build into him. You're able to tank up a lot more of the Queen of Pain. And then you can also return Queen of Pain. If you're able to get some nice speed with the attacks that come through, get some nice triggers on that call snap, and it cancels the blink animation of Queen of Pain. And sometimes you just need that couple of little animation cancels, and you get a little bit extra time to right-click into her, and then you can bring it down. Reserve time. And we'll have to see if that is what NS is thinking as his final pickup. Lion's Pride, we'll probably get a little bit more of our answer right now. Do we see who is it going to be for the offlane? Even if it's a Windrunner pickup, it could still be the standard lanes for Lion's Pride, where they just pull up towards the top, let Nakes farm up. Vengeful Spirit is a selection, however, which isn't a real setup kind of thing. It's a very kind of like scouting slash attack negative armor style which Lions Pride doesn't really have a lot to follow up with. But with this, I do wonder if they're still looking for some semi-aura strat. Right now, it's only for the Vengeful Spirit, but if we look at a little bit more negative armor and add like a Shadow Fiend in towards the mix for Lion's Pride, it could work. Beastmaster for the offlane for Lion's Pride. Another bit of Inner Beast, combining that up with Nakes. Nakes and Quap are already going to be working together. That's where our Nakes spawn's going to come from, by Queen of Pain jumping in with a Lifestealer like Insider. And then that kind of burst damage is meant for Rubick and Lashrak. But Lion's Pride, it's still questionable about that lanes, even with that VS pickup. I was waiting for something that was a little bit more obvious as an offlaner or a safe laner on the top solo. We didn't really get it. And NS, well, a little bit of microphone feedback, that is. Yeah, that still last pit to come up here from NS. I'm assuming Invoker, but maybe he has other ideas for that mid-solo. Something that can go up against Queen of Pain. Something that can either, like, just stand his ground and then wait for the support rotation in. Or completely screw it up and go for the Naga Siren. We're adding another core to the mix now. Which makes our two cores, which will be Naga and Luna. But this makes an aggressive tri-lane for Virtus Pro, in fact. So Lashrak and Rubick will be our supports. We'll be heading with Naga Siren up towards that top lane. And we're going to go Ensnare, Rubick pickup, and then Lashrak as well with his follow-up stun. 10 seconds. And that puts Luna into our bottom lane and Darkseer for the solo mid up against the Queen of Pain, which is a very interesting combination to have. Unless I try and throw Luna in the middle, but that's a dangerous place to throw her because you know you're going to get ganked up a hell of a lot. But that is meant as an aggressive tri-lane, what Virtus Pro has. It's not really a tower pushing style lineup. So unless they feel like Lion's Pride, if Lion's Pride are looking to run that aggressive tri-lane with Coddle VS and as well as Nakes, they're going to lose their supports very, very quickly if Virtus Pro run a defensive tri-lane. And Klinks is the final selection. Yeah, Lion's Pride are running an aggressive tri-lane. Klinks is there, going to go Funnic style on the safe lane. Up on the top. And they're going to send Nakes, Coddle and VS down towards the bottom. Virtus Pro are probably thinking exactly the same thing as I am for this. Not that I'm saying that NS... Seriously, will you stop doing that microphone? Yeah, I'm assuming NS is thinking the same thing as me. I'm assuming. There's always a lot of assumptions. All right, so we're good to go. For the guy, too, who said there's no lag, finally, the new hardware works. New hardware's not here yet. It was only ordered today. But with German efficiency, it'll arrive in a few days. So maybe you just got lucky on the live stream today. Or maybe your own 3D TV is starting to implement a couple of the fixes, which I know are supposed to be coming out, or coming our way, and to be happening over the next couple of days. A couple of weeks. And that should make things a lot smoother for you, depending on where you are. Especially if you're on the Eastern Europe side, or if you're down in Southeast Asia, things are supposed to get a lot better for you in those regions. So, yeah, just a little bit of a nice... Yeah! I seriously must have pulled something on this microphone. I must have. Sorry. Stop it. I know it's doing it too. I know it's doing it. Maybe I'm the only person that can hear this. Ah, see, you heard that. You would have heard that. It's me destroying the microphone one bit at a time. So you know what it's like too. Everything I hear in my ears is amplified in comparison to what you hear. So every single little problem, little detail I can hear in the sound that sometimes doesn't transfer over to the live stream, but it still frustrates me with it. And whenever anything goes wrong, it annoys me a lot. All right, so let's run through who's got what. So we'll have Santa as the Darkseer, and that puts Crazy onto our Lashrak. So KSI, it's a support Naga with NS as Rubick, and then Airman to cap off as Luna. Either that or they're just changing around their roles. But we'll look at their item build a little bit more into this game. And it puts Android, our Vengeful Spirit supporter, Stalk LP. He'll be onto the Klinks, Vigos, Queen of Pain for him, Massacre onto the Nakes. And that leaves our old man Cottle as the man who should be known as Zach. Because that's what I would actually call him with a Z, with an X8K. Zach. Yeah, but we do have a very quick pause, so it's a quick a quick time for Lions Pride. Of course, Lions Pride, they do have a couple of games to get through tonight. They're going up against Virtus Pro to start with, and then they stay here inside the lobby and go up against Team Liquid directly after. And then following that matchup, we have a bit of a fun match. I say a fun match, it should be really, really funky. The guys have brought down no Tidehunter, Turtle Masters, with their level 1 Roshan amazing strat, which was the obvious level 1 Roshan come and stop us strat. They will be going up against Evil Geniuses as our last game of the night. There is a break in the defense as well tomorrow, just something to bear in mind that there will be the break. And I will be having a rest tomorrow because we've had a lot of days casting. Ever since I got back from Malaysia, every single day there has been a live stream available for your viewing pleasure. So, as of tomorrow, there will be a break of one day. And then we return for 5 days straight of the defense. So if you want to check out the details, head over to joindata.com and check out the match ticket details. Or you can head to the-defense.com. And you'll also find out all the information you want to know. If you've been wondering about any of the drafts, any about the competitions, anywhere, they are available in our match ticker. In case you actually didn't know, all the drafts are being recorded in our match ticker. There's even a team and player ranking database. If you want to get picky about this right now, we have Lions Pride, who are ranked 38 out of all the current active teams in the world of Dota, and Virtus Pro fighting in the rank 14. So that is our matchup that we have this evening. They are, of course, a little bit lower down in Group A of the defense, but there are still a lot of games yet to be played. Every team must play 7 games in their group stage matches for the defense. Man, these guys are doing this again. They need a quick pause. NS and KSI, they sat here before when they were playing as a Dyasi, waiting for a gank, and funny enough, they never got the right positioning for it. This time around, they're waiting for the bottom lane to come down. So they're expecting the aggressive tri lane to come out from Lions Pride, which is very, very obvious. And Klinks, I think he was hoping for a solo, and he'll be up against Santa. Not the easiest hero to try and get last hits and denies against. Even if you do have Searing Arrows, you'll be burning through your mana very, very fast. The fact that Crazy, he is going to be playing that mid-solo Latrak. So we see Core Latrak solo mid coming out from Virtus Pro. And that leaves on our bottom lane the support Nargisiren. And you can see what she's here for. You can definitely see what she's here for. It's a nice nuke very early on. 130 damage with negative armor of 2 points. NS will hold him in position while all that happens. And then Luna comes in, and everyone's got a nice bit of extra right-click on the bottom lane, even though Nargisiren isn't really great for harassment. She's just going to be used as an ultimate. That's going to be what it's going to be, like nothing but an ultimate. And Massacre's down here, and he won't want to level up Rage. Maybe they'll wait until they see what he's going to level up. But the fact that Nyx is down here, they instantly know that this is a tri lane. Say hello to Coddle. But the main ones they won't want to focus. You see Coddle. She's the first one to take damage. Now the pickup. Riptun as well. Keep the right clicks going. And Nenez should be able to pick it off. Does successfully do so. Gets a VS stun to the face. Now trying to run himself away. He's got a couple of issues or a couple of illusions that are chasing down. But Nenez will live and we'll pop the salve and get back in towards this mix very, very quickly. Welcome to our first blood. In the meantime, it'll be Vigos going up against Latrak. Latrak already starting off with a little bit more of a harassment build. He's using Split Earth just so he knows it didn't stun the hero. It was looking for the creep wave instead. It was looking for the last hits. That gave him his bottle. And that means any kind of harassment that Vigos does very early on will be negated. And Vigos also go for a different style build. We see him with a lot of consumables very early on, then the Ironwood branches encircle it. So he's going to try and control the runes and then move himself into a different position. And that's going to be going in with a Null Talisman, going in with the Magic Wand very early on, and just rotating around with these runes. Either that or he does buy a bottle, because he's getting pretty close to it. Got another move on bottom. Yep, Rubik's on the way in. They'll be looking for this Coddle again. Pick him up. Throw him down, Riptide does the job. Actually goes through all three heroes with the Lucent Beam and the right click. Remember the bonus damage which is coming out from the Lucent Beam of Airman. And this is now Eventual Spirit going down. Moving onto the Nakes, all the right click damage in the world. Lucent Beam as well as a Feybolt. This is a fantastic lane coming out from Virtus Pro. They're really making the most out of this negative armor and the burst damage of Nargisiren. Not to mention that she has a hold now too. You use the Ensnare, we got 2 points up in Riptide. So 160 damage and now negative armor reduction. And you've got one, and you've got four. So Eventual Spirit is the easy one. But then again, it also shows in the focus that Virtus Pro is doing when they're looking at the different heroes. You see them instantly focus down. stun the Coddle. Then they move over. They look for the Nakes or Ventral Spirit. Depends who's lower and who's taking more damage at the time. Nakes can be capped off at the end of it because they kind of thought he was going to go Enrage, but he went Open Wounds as well as Feast. That's his first things. With a lineup that's killing you off as much as it is, even with that ensnare, you just pop up the Rage, and I believe it does break it. And then Virtus Pro, they don't want to keep the pressure on too much. They also want to still find their farm, find their CS. And that's what they're doing, and wow! Nice CS for the Darkseer. This Klinks is... Oh, wait, let me just do this. That makes a lot more sense. Oh, hello, top lane too. Ventral Spirit. Looking for Santa just to drop a little bit low. And Santa should be realizing this rotation's going to come. That's why he's got 2 points up in Surge. And Surge is down, and now Ventral Spirit will see it. Rupi will get a kill on the bottom lane, but there's the stun we're looking for. Needs 2 probably searing arrows with the right clicks from Ventral Spirit. Actually, no aura, and the negative armor not doing enough. Screaming. Vigos rotates up and gets the pick off.
Pain is the best.
But that means we have Queen of Pain leaving the middle lane. Sure, that's it's still a kill, so that's worth the rotation. But it could have been handled by Ventral Spirit as well as Klinks. So just waste a little bit of time. And we already got 26 vanilla up on the Darkseer. And that's pure creep wave as well. So I see him up at level 5 in a bit. Well, on the bottom lane, how much farm have we managed to get for this Nakes? 8 for 5. 8 for 5 farm up against the Luna, who's 12 for 1. So, it's more focused on kills. But this Klinks also, 22 for 2, not too shabby. Even crazy getting out CS here in the middle lane. They better have some kind of timing in thought for this. Because right now it's like El Pride, they should be in ahead, they're not. Kill count's the only thing that's really balancing that out. But the gold advantage from farm should be a little bit higher for El Pride, even though, well, no, 3 for 0, 4 for 0, 4, 3, 3, 0, 1. It's just more on this Quap. It did go Boots and Bottle. Again, we've got Android moving up towards the top lane, looking for Santa, who once again is diving behind the tower. Probably still trying to finish up his Tranquil Boots. This time not surging through the trees, trying to bait out the Ventral Spirit. Whoop, hearing a little bit of a death pack and giving us nice bonus damage. Santa still on the run. Right click it down, and now is there any levels in Strafe? Nope, just trying to right click Santa out, but he TPs all the way back to base.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Heals up and sniped out the creep wave. This Lushrak burst damage is really going to couple up nicely when he rotates down the bottom lane. That's if they can hold Nakes in position. Remember still, he's got that rage. So for 3 seconds, well, maximum 6, he's able to pop off that rage and have a basic BKB. And all these magic abilities just will do nothing. Coddle Blast was searching out there for crazy. Plus Vigos was trying to dive him a little bit further as well. Wow. Blink and it's over.
That was the sound of your
and that
death.
Is a level 7 Queen of Pain now. It was only a level 6 when she went for that one. Pick up, throw in range of the tower, but blink out and that will disjoint the attack. And gets more mana as well from Coddle, who's in the neighborhood. But won't be able to take up that rune. Darkseer was searching for it. Rune's on bottom, so haste rune down there. And now Crazy returns with NS. Well, and hello KSI, able to chase down this Coddle with a haste rune. Maybe even think about, well, ensnare in a moment. She doesn't really need it. Gonna force a little bit more support in. Again, Santa, man, this guy, seriously, he is so persistent at doing this. Most Darkseers will give up on this after a while. Wow, Queen of Pain went down in mid. Well, Shrek's able to pick that one off, must have been out of position when he got stunned. And now Santa surges, VS follows up with the stun. The range is there, but he's around 3 heroes. Looking for the TP out. The stun's already gone to Santa. Ah, again. This could be the most frustrating thing in the world for Lions Pride. They lose their Queen of Pain in middle. Looks like halfway down the river as well. Really out of position. She knew about that rune on bottom being taken. But ensnare would set up, depending on where she tries to blink to. Could have blinked, and that was probably what happened. The blink into the wrong position on the map. And that was probably where Lushrak was just waiting for him. Remember too, Lushrak's got a nice amount of burst damage. Vigos is down here on the bottom lane now.
Bottom
but through Lushrak's burst damage, like you get that split earth off, you get 3 points up in line, so you get 205 burst damage from that. Then you add the Riptide on top of that with the negative armor reduction, so 190 damage and 4 negative armor. And then on top of that, you got 3 points up in Fade Bolt. So even more damage coming out. All of this burst able to nuke down all these heroes. But all of this burst can't happen if their silencer are getting ganked off and they don't find the rhymes to keep the support up. And that's what I'm a little bit concerned about. Whoa, hello. Blinked down by Vigos. What's he wanting to get? Apart from just the TP scroll. No, he's just chilling on the sides. Searching for M and all searching for experience. Sandra again returns towards the top lane, and again, Vengeful Spirit will scout him out. Look for a bit of a body block. There's a VS done before he did the surge, though. And then another TP out by Santa. Soon that won't work anymore. Stalk LP will have enough damage. He didn't pop off the strafe just then to do the damage, which is a little bit more surprising. I think he's just happy to see the Darkseer waste 135 gold all the time. And it'll be Naga who comes up towards the top lane. No points in mirror images, so she can't use the... Well, hello, Vigos. He's a long way in. He's searching for crazy. I suppose he's got his burst damage back up again, so hey, why not? A double damage rune to boot.
Radiance
and crazy hides on the top.
Attack.
He's going to rotate up towards that top lane. Combine up with Santa. We've still got Airman farming up in the bottom lane, but he's not getting as much, nowhere near as much as Klinx is. Klinx is starting to pick up the jungle, but he's also starting to pick up that Orchid. And that's when time is going to get rough for Virtus Pro. It's when the silencers will be there. KSI looking for an opening. Able to find one. Riptiding up on Klinx. He instantly goes Invis. Oh, sorry, a little bit delayedly goes on Invis. And then they move on the Vengeful Spirit. Ensnare, Edict, as well as Lightning. Doesn't even need the Lashrak follow-up stun. 4 points in that Lightning. And then they get rid of the Tier 1 tower as well. And then down the bottom lane. Coddle? In a position where he really shouldn't be. Now TP in towards the mid lane, well, the T1 tower will go down. Santa, gotta be careful. Vigos still has a lot of burst damage. Dance it off, scream, ulties, it hits. And so there's the last right click of Vigos. It wasn't enough with that amount of damage from just her nukes to kill off Santa. But Santa, a suicidal TP, really. In the middle of a Naix as well as the Queen of Pain, even if it wasn't going to be the Quap ulti with already the attack with the double damage. Naix still had the infest option. If he was inside the Queen of Pain and they just jumped in close, but Naix would have been dead. Now Riptide again. Lashrak able to get the sun up as well as the lightning damage through it, but gonna lose his own life. Naga, maybe not. Rage gonna wear off for Lifestealer. And Lashrak, I think he wants this. I really think he wants this. Here's a guy with the stun. Gonna turn it off in time. Oh no! A little bit out of mistiming there. One more right click up the hill. Vengeful Spirit is on 19 HP. There it goes. No miss hit up the hill as well. And Snare, no mana for it. Want to chase it down. Lashrak's on off target here. So just missing that communication perfectly between KSI as well as Crazy. Not the easiest thing in the world to achieve, but they tried it. Didn't 100% work, but they still managed to pick off the Vengeful Spirit. Now going to add some pressure to the Tier 1 tower in mid. Massacre's on the front lines. Lightning won't bounce through to win, but he's got not enough support here. And at the same time, Rubick going to come in. Looks to a pickup. He sees Vigos, and does he get steal an ability as well? Pick up, throw down, blink away. Vigos caught inside the trees. He's going to be there for another 5 seconds. Nice cuddle blast. That's a lot of damage going the way of NS. He's going to get himself away from this one. Vengeful Spirit can't get close enough. Now Queen of Pain able to blink herself away. Yeah, and there's the surge away. Make sure Rubick's safe so we can salve up. A lot of support rotated down for this one while Amir's trying to take the T1 tower on bot. It's like Rubick is forced up towards the top lane as well as Crazy to push him back off the T1 tower. And Vigos is looking for a snipe off. Again, he looks for Darkseer. And again, he's going to find him. So go for the sting, go for the scream, and ulti, he's going to hold it. And finds him. Ulti, worth it, worth it. On cooldown. 13 seconds. Again, Santa escapes death.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
T1 tower hasn't gone down yet in the bottom lane. M's gonna arrive just in time for the Cutter Blast. Lose just a little of life, but he's got Tranquils, so he'll feel fine. Tranquils, Drums, Wand, Aquila. So everything he'd normally have. And Klinx, 12 minutes in, has Orchid. 415 gold per minute, not too shabby. No kills, just assists. In fact, look at that Rubick, 4 kills on his name. 4 for the Lashrak as well. And now Airman. He feels something is wrong, but he still wants farm. And because he makes this move, he is now dead. The Orchid will hit, Coddle will charge up the blast. And that is going to be Airman going down. So Coddle Yep, there we go. Orc it up. Right click it. And tries to TP out. Actually, that's going to help Matt if the Colour Blast didn't hit. My pop from the Orc. No, he won't. He gets out safely. That's going to be frustration hell again for Lion's Pride. Pick up and throw down. Massacre gets inside the rage, but the ensnare will still hold him there. The Shraxxon also did his job, and now going up with the Edict damage, he infests into one of the healthiest creeps you can find. Another Riptide is up the sleeve to KSI. He does it too. Try and slow him down. There's your ensnare. Another rage, but he can't walk out this one. Lashrak will just wait for the rage to wear off, and now can follow up with a stun. Can't get the lightning right. There we go. Sorry, can't get the timing right. The lightning is right, though. Woo! Hello, Quap! That was not an air ball. Did hit it there on NS. Pick up and throw out. Supports or TP. KSI will be forced to walk away. He can't TP out just yet. There's no mana for him to do so. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Luna popping up that Luzon Beam. Might have actually taken the bottom tower. But I don't think this is going to be that easy for Stork. Both Santa, oh, they're going to find, yeah, too far out. And then Santa can easily disrupt him with the VAC. I think he's looking for a little bit more, two up onto the Clinks, but not going to be the case. 12-3, what's our advantage-wise? Still hovering just under 3,000. Experience starting to go up the way of Virtus.pro as well. And as far as towers do, look, we've got, well, only one tower claimed by Virtus.pro. And they've lost three towers, and they still hold a 2.5k advantage. Still put a lot of that down to the amount of farm that Clinks has been able to achieve. As well as now the attempting rotation for kills. Hasn't worked 100%, Naga. No ulti this time around. Ooh, gets a Riptide off from Vigos, but Vigos wants out and LP wants a kill. But again, he starts off on this Orchid attack. It's a quick pause coming out from Crazy. I'm guessing something's a little bit wrong here. It's an illusion rune that wanted to be stolen. But this Clinks, he's chasing these kills with the Orchid, but he's not really getting himself into that prepared position. There's no one on no life. Everyone he's starting to attack has been full life, or has at least got some level, like decent level. So we've got 910 life points, as well as 9 armor to get through on this Naga Siren. Sure, your silence and the damage you take is an extra 25%. But that's still a lot of life points to get through, even for a level 11 Clinks, who is buffed up by the Death Pact. And of course, Searing Arrows. That's not going to be enough to instantly kill him off. KSI, if he jukes correctly in these trees, he might even be able to haul Clinks out for the moment. Like, we already see that hero is moving down. Yeah, Ammon's already starting to make a little bit of a movement back. Santa's also running back. That's kind of because they're leaving the tower anyway, but if KSI can juke it long enough, support might arrive. Not really a loose and beam can help with that, but maybe if Darkseer can search himself, 1 second left, well, not even that, it's like half a second left on that, he might be able to get himself away. Well, NS as well as Lashrak, are they going to finally bring down this tower in mid? It's got 68 life points. Kind of surprising too, this thing hasn't been denied yet. Considering you do have a hero like Lashrak, even though it's 1 point up in Edict, it's enough to help push out. And I mean, sure, that last hit in the tower. And you see that large amount of cash coming the way of Lashrak. We're looking at a Bloodstone Crazy here. All the kills in the world wants to have his way. Looks like we have a bit more of an extended pause. That's a little bit longer than 1 minute here, Crazy. A reminder as well, just while I've got you guys sitting here, just relaxing, if you want to open up your browsers. I was watching a live stream last night, I was linked to it, and this guy was just like, you know what, follow me, subscribe to me. I sponsor a child, I use $40 a day, and I make sure this child's got food and care and everything else. And I use it as a tax write-off, so it's a win-win situation. KSI, man, really? He actually duked that. Kind of should have been looking over at that one. Inside the trees, locked him out with the mud columns. And they didn't find KSI in time. And now he'll go for somebody else. Supports, that's the heroes he should have been targeting. I say supports. Naga is actually technically a support. TP out, and now NS. Orking it up, right-click, blocked in position by LP. There was just no easy way to escape from that. A little bit of a spree's been ended. Nice a pickup. 4-1 and 5-1 was on that Rubik as well as Lautrec. I was talking about the problems of Virtus Pro during the two defense games ago. And the fact they got nothing up on their supports, but this time around it's completely the other way. Hello, Yasha. So damage dealing arms as well coming the way of Luna. She's starting off with that too. No BKB to start with. Might get that next and just leave it as a Yasha and not finish up the Manda style. But for right now, having drums feels that is enough strength. Just fakes pushing up the middle lane. Sans is already up with that mech. And should be looking over towards having... Well, he's got enough mana pull, so he won't need the arcanes, but we'll be wanting to get that Hood of Defiance as well as Pipe up as early as possible. And then they're able to dive up against Queen of Pain as well as Coddle. Use that Pipe for a really... for a good purpose. And number two, that Orchid is magical. Denied. So once you get that Hood effect up on him... It's going to be a lot harder for Klingsa to snipe off Santa. Oh, Vigos came in to the... He blinked in the middle of Luna. The Eclipse has done the shot. Vigos blink away. Can't get it. He started the animation, but the last right click out from M and finished the job. And now they'll force the Tier 2 tower in mid. Edict, 2 points up this time around. There is fortification. They're deciding not to use it. Looking for more support. Is there a recall coming in here from Coddle? It's just the blast and doesn't get any of the creep wave. Klink's looking through the rear. Gonna search out for NS. Lautrec yukes down the creep wave. Both stunned as well as lightning on cooldown for the moment, but the tower has already taken a fall. Ammon will cop a Coddle blast. And Vengeful Spirit would have got spotted very, very quickly then. But it's far enough away for safety. And then again, another pause coming out here from Lion's Pride. Yeah, I'm down with NS. I'm down with NS, yeah. 1 minute, pause, go, sorry, why? So we'll just see why the hell we have so many pauses. Admins will be on the job for this one. All right, so now Lion's Pride, good to go again. And because of this, Vengeful Spirit, able to walk away. Mask is still up here on the top lane. Luna easily able to harass him back. In fact, if he wants to, he could have chased this one out. This has a nice amount of damage with that Yasha. And you kind of see that, like, Rage protects him from a loose and beam to stun him out of here, but until he gets... Oh my god, we're starting to build up on that armlet. Finish the armlet. Where the mech has to be flying down too. Nice items coming out. And that's for Coddle. These items are still coming nice and late. Their advantage is still the fact that Luna has gone for more of a damage style item build. I really want to see what Ammon goes up as his next item. If we get a Mithril Hammer on Ogre Club, we know exactly where we're going. So again, we have another pause. Klinks is having some issues. The highest farmer for Lion's Pride. Just can't seem to make it work. It just doesn't go up. Yeah. But anyway, back to what I was talking about before we had this pause. And if there's a reconnect, I don't see a kill happening on the map. There's just a whole bunch of blue lines. Yeah. Should be following everyone on Twitter and Facebook and doing all that kind of jazz. If you don't know, on Toby1Dota, you'll find me on Twitter, Facebook, as well as YouTube. Published a recent, like, I'm doing a whole bunch of video blogs over on youtube.com/Toby1Dota. You can find them all over there. And for people also who are wondering about our YouTube channel, Vigos, wrong place to be. Again, able to blink away to safety and then bottle. While Ammon's on the run from Klinks. Maybe a little overcommitment by Ammon. Try and juke it around the fog of war. And LP, he does juke it. LP wouldn't have enough damage in time. He needed three clicks in then. Couldn't do it. And Ammon using his experience for the Fog of War to get his advantage. He bought dust and then cancelled it. Now if he just dropped that on the deck for the courier. Moving in towards that mid lane. Again looking for Vigos. As KSI kind of wants to push up it a little bit further. And Vigos having to defend. He comes in range of that Iron Shell creep, dropping him low. It's kind of lucky they're not looking for him. Instead, they're moving up for the Klinks. We don't have gems, we have dust that's there for KSI. And we'll just look for him. And now they see the clinks, now the dust can pop. It's there to start with, dust as well. Nowhere to go, invis. Right click him down, already got the negative armor. Follow up, Lathrak's done. Back in, lightning, fade bolt, everything they need. And clinks is dead. And this should be a tier 2 tower up on the top lane. But yeah, for those guys wondering about our YouTube channel, yes, we are aware, unfortunately, it was dropped down by YouTube. We're hoping this is an automatic system thing. We're still trying to work and find out exactly what the problem is, but we have made several attempts to contact YouTube, and we'll hopefully have it sorted a lot sooner than later. For now, though, all the VODs will still appear over on O3DTV like normal. They do have a couple of issues with their players, but hopefully they'll be sorting them out. Oh, nice. Really nice. KSI, easier setup for the ultimate. There goes our first instant. We're going to pick up an ability. Still NS, unable to steal anything. Back in with a stun. Double kill goes the way of Airman. Really surprised still that NS decided during that engagement, instead of actually stealing an ability, he was going to stand there and right click everybody. Radiant's middle tower is under. I don't think I've actually seen him use his ultimate once. Or use someone else's ultimate once, I should say. Another blink away to safety. Vigos just hanging in the wings. Sees NS. And NS is moving up. This could be nice ward. And now he steals blink. Exactly what NS probably wanted. Might be the reason why he's saving his ultimate. Blink initiation that gets to come out. Like, it's basically a free 2,150 gold. And it comes the way of NS. He bleeds a little bit for it, but it works for him. And now because he's got this blink, he can move around. He'll look for the ward to the Dire side. Now he's carrying the gem. So there's nowhere for Klinks to hide. And this means also no places for Klinks to look. We're seeing NS checking all the normal ward spots. So whenever you have a Klinks on the field, you've got to have that extra vision. You've got to be looking around. And now blink in, pick up, not even a chance for rage. He gets it when he finally gets down, but Lathrak couldn't get the right timing for the stun. And they're inside the creep. It's the wrong one they're attacking. He jumps himself back out again. But another Lucent Beam. Rage on cooldown for the moment. Remember this little ancient stack over here on the side? Lion's Pride have been trying to farm it up for a little bit now. But they're only halfway through it. Inverse Pro adding pressure to the tier 2 tower is going to make him fear that a little bit more. They might find it. They've got to get in there and farm up the remaining part of that stack. Oh, there goes our dewarding. And back in towards that bottom lane Airman. He's still a long way up, but still easily able to harass that Nakes back again. Blink in, and they managed to pick up VS. Drop him down, one Lucent Beam, ensnare behind it, and the Riptide out from Airman. I say right click by Airman. Riptide coming out there from KSI. And have they moved down and seen that stack? No, it's still nine types, even though they ran up here. They ran the quick way up. Oh, hello, one TP out. Lathrak sitting back in, Lifestealer. Ensnared, held, right click, Airman's just opening up. That feast is helping him a little bit, but this time there's no infestation. And NS made sure he was never going to run away. Even if that rage wore off, he was never going to be able to run away. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Crazy will take care of the mid. Dire's tier 2 tower goes down on the bot. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And both LP as well as Vigos, I'm 100% sure where they want to go from here. Vigos still with all this burst damage and no one to kill. He does have the cash for a BKB, but he could also be saving for a very quick Aghanim Scepter and just feel that pressure coming his way. Try to make him think he's going BKB, then appear with Aghanim's like, woo! NS, again this blink going to work. Fade Bolt down, stand up, back in again. And Vengeful Spirit can't run from this, even with wand charges. The damage from a level 4 Iron Shell is too much. So another kill going the way here of Virtus Pro. 10,000 gold advantage, almost 10,000 worth of experience. Just pressure from every angle. And Luna just loving life here. All the farm in the world, full mana style. She did complete it before going for the BKB. Even right now, I'm not sure she will even go for a BKB. If you start seeing evasion come out, the only thing that's going to hurt her is the magical damage. There's a BKB up at Lathrak. He'll try and take as much as he can. But if we see that pipe out from Santa, He's starting to build it. I'm wondering if this is the majority of it. Yeah, it is. It's majority of pipe. We put that pipe up on top of Luna. She can deal with most of the burst damage out from Lion's Pride. And then just go into a little bit more lifesteal. Put the money into the hood instead. Just a quick Hood of Defiance. Blink by Vigos, looking up. There's our first ensnare. BKB will pop, and KSI doesn't really want to be involved in this. And then we see the Naga Orbman go. BKB is going to wear off from Vigos in 2 seconds' time. And then he's affected. Massacre is the one they want. They get the pickup, they throw him down. Look at the Ryclix coming in. Then they're back in again. Into the ensnare. Vengeful Spirit's gone. Cataclysm tries to help him out. One blink away to safety is a Queen of Pain running down south. At the same time, Klinks is on the run from Menace, the man that can see him. But they want the tier 2 tower on top. Two heroes in the sidelines remove that last remaining outer tower. And Ammon wants a couple more of herself. Push out as fast as possible. Cataclysm will slow this down a little bit. And probably will make Virtus.pro think twice about pushing in, because you never want to push in on a Cataclysm as well as Queen of Pain. We did at least get our answer to the question, was Queen of Pain buying BKB or not? Answer was yes. I got a feeling he needed that safety, of course, with the Naga Oldman. And there's a Naga Oldman coming through with support Naga.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
So you never really have a major concern. Oh, apart from if Vigos gets caught out like that, then you have a major concern. 50 seconds with no Queen of Pain. And they're pinging Rosh. That's where Rubick wants to go. So Ines makes the call. Roshan to go down. No ward up on the high ground, but with Queen of Pain on the sidelines, they feel confident enough. There's no Nakes bomb that can happen. There's no jump in that will follow. And this will now be Roshan. An easy death. Or an easy kill, I should say, for Virtus.pro. And that's it. I guess the Immortal goes the way of Luna. With an Eagle Song. And that Butterfly isn't far off. That'll be done by 27 minutes at this farming rate. And looks like Klinks just looking for a snipe off. And this Death Pact now runs out. Probably was looking for a new one. And the Black King Bar comes his way, so we have another Magic Immune hero. Nakes through the Rage. Queen of Pain through the BKB, as well as Klinks through the BKB. But as we've seen, that right-click damage coming out from Luna is more than any kind of BKB or Rage is able to let you handle, because it's physical damage. It doesn't care. All he's got to do is just keep right-clicking. Or auto-attacking. Either way, it works. And with the Butterfly, he'll have Evasion on top of that one. Santa too far out. Orchid Cataclysm can hit him pretty hard as well. Couldn't see it because he's walking through the tree line. And then the follow-up stun and just destruction. Ghost Scepter bought a little bit of time for him, but not much. He tried to Ghost Scepter and Pipe. That's why he didn't take as much damage from that Cataclysm. It'll be a while before he'll get to respawn. Well, hello. Vengeful Spirit. And they're going to team up. Snare again on Massacre. Riptide does that right click damage, takes care of him as well as Lifestealer in a moment. Naga pops the Ullman. VS tried to swap him back out of here. I don't think they'd realize how close they were to Klinks. And now right click is not enough to kill off Massacre. Does slow him down again, and KSI looking to finish the job. Comes in with one easy Riptide. Core Body will bounce over the top of the rest of Virtus.pro. Lestrank's done. That was a little bit rando. Vigos blinks away. Cotta Blast. Yeah, still that BKB effect up on Lestrank. And NS, smart enough to avoid. Queen of Pain wants away as well. Have they got heal for NS? No, he has to have to go all the way back to base. Evan's only got heal on himself, but what he does have right now is enough money for a full Butterfly. So now we're going to add Evasion on top of it all. Grab another top tier item. Is that the full Bloodstone? Energy booster, point booster. It's at least the soul booster coming the way of Crazy. He's just got to dismantle and then reassemble inside the courier. So, yep, there we go. Soul booster, hands it back. Because he went the BKB first, really slowed down that Bloodstone, but he'll have it at the end of the day. Ammon still hasn't spent his cash, but the courier hasn't arrived back at base just yet. Just a very farmed up Santa. Still not the highest. Second highest. Klinks has managed to fall behind a little bit. With the BKB and Orchid, he's lost so much of his bite. Can also throw it down like who he's attacking. Like, you look through the kill count here, and I'm looking at a Lefrank with only one death, and a Rubick with one death, and we have a Klinks on the field who got a very early Orchid. And then you look over, and Nakes is 1-7, 0-8 on that Vengeful Spirit. These supports are just so far behind. There's been more damage coming out from this Naga, as well as Rubick combination, which we're gonna see here again. Riptide it down, one more loose and beam. VS swaps up towards the high ground, back down again. Santa's gonna dive it in, look for an extra hit. M is the one that gets VS stunned up. Iron Shield damage now finally happened from Santa. 20 HP left on that Vengeful Spirit. They want to go for a bigger boy, and it's already trying to TP out of here. He had enough damage done to him. And now an infestation to a Radiant creep. Pops back out of it, Coddle's on low life. But they've been forcing down this mid tower in the meantime. That's why fortification has to come out. And the Coddle Blast will force him back again, but not far enough. Back down, and now Lifestealer! Able to live, toggle the armlet, but not for long. Dire straight away. Dark Seer's ultimate comes up. And Linus Prime doesn't want to go through that one. Naga wants in, though. There's the ensnare. Vengeful Spirit back for round two. Lestrike's done on Lightning. Way too much damage for her to deal with. And Ehrman, living life on the edge. Klink still has Orca, but he's not using it. He pops the BKB and runs. If he popped Orchid, then he would have gone through Ehrman's Aegis the Immortal at least. But because of this, now he'll pop off Tranquil, starts to heal up. And the Bouncing Glaives go through all the racks. Yeah, should be focusing on that melee. And does do so now. And no hero wants to come in close. What do we get stolen? Again, another Blink coming the way of NS. Mid racks just easily forced down. Virtus Pro move back. Luna, Butterfly, and yeah, not quite sure she meant to buy that one. Not quite sure Vigor's meant to be called out that far. Pops the ultimate, but doesn't matter. The BKB meant she was invulnerable, so could still be attacked. And now, Eclipse to pop in the middle of the creep wave as well. Ehrman just doesn't give a crap right now. Coddle just melts. Quapoldi, not enough to kill off Ehrman. He turns around, and Vigor's picked up. Keep the Rykliss going. It's sitting on no life whatsoever. Gem is dropped, Coddle will buy back. He just wants to get rid of this Aegis Immortal of Ehrman, but Ehrman wants it to go. He wants it now. He walked into the wave. He saw it even being channeled up. We'll come back up again. One quick loose and beam, and that's the end of Vengeful Spirit. Right, just Nagasara and then picks it up. How long before Aegis was reclaimed? Yeah, 30 seconds. So he wanted to die and have full life again. GG, well played, is the call. Ghost Hunter buys a little bit of time, but then Lightning out from Crazy with just enough mana for it. And that is going to be a convincing game here to Virtus Pro. Next game coming up next, Lions Pride going to try the luck up against another one of the Giants in their group. This is kind of like the hardest night of their lives. They have to go up against Team Liquid. It's their next matchup here in the defense group stages. And our final game of the night will be Evil Geniuses going up against the Tide Defeaters, the Turtle Masters. That'll be coming up, I think it, what was it? 19:20 CET. That's going to be coming up at 21:45. So just before 10 o'clock. But it might start a little bit earlier as well. Just stay tuned. We'll return. More defense action will get to come your way. Hope you'll enjoy the show. If you miss any of the matches, remember you'll have to go to the O3D TV channel or just join Dota.com. All the VODs are embedded over there, and you'll be able to find them there. They are available on 3D TV right now. As we said before, our YouTube channel is having a couple of problems, as in it was automatically shut down by YouTube. We are trying to bring it back up again, so keep your eyes peeled. It should hopefully return in some decent amount of time. And keep your eyes peeled, of course, for everything defense. Coming up shortly, Lions Pride goes up against Team Liquid.
I said good day, sir!